15 years ago, you had a vision, and you've built this incredible capability around personal surgery and patient-specific medical device. How did it happen?
I think our original vision was really looking at three-dimensional models as three-dimensional x-rays, you know, so kind of taking an x-ray and really putting it in a surgeon's hand. Taking it from there forward, there were a lot of things that kind of happened in the middle to get us to personalized surgery, I mean, as we know it today, and what really has led to kind of the tools and techniques that form, you know, the core of what is personalized surgery.
How has medical modeling changed, and how has the exponential developments in 3D systems technology and 3D printing as a whole, including the digital thread that allows you to do the modeling, be it in haptics or in CAD, all the way from a CT scan or an MRI to something that you can hold in your hands and today actually implant or do reconstructive work with. How has it changed for you?
Things that really have been able to propel us to the next level. We've had several kind of plateaus or new levels, and one of those was the ability to interact with the CT scans and the MRIs. So the ability to interact in a very fluid way with some of the haptics technologies. Yeah. Stereolithography has continued to advance, and today we have the ability to output, you know, tools that are biocompatible and tools that are very accurate for use in surgery. So that's a key kind of component to the system. And then other software pieces along the way too to allow us to not only design an implant, but actually perform surgery in the computer. Last but not least, implants, you know, and actually printing in titanium, which has opened up completely new, you know, opportunities for us.
So when I first came to hear about medical modeling, it was around the time that you were doing the Egyptian conjoined twin separation.
Yes, you know, we were asked by a team of surgeons in Dallas, Texas, who had just planned to receive on a pro bono basis a case, an interesting case, yeah, of two twin boys joined at the head. We were asked very early to provide modeling assistance. We'd worked with the main surgeon, Dr. Kenneth Salyer, for years before that, and he knew how valuable models could be, and he thought of any case, this one really could benefit. So he asked, he said, would you support it? I said, whatever we can do to support it, we'd support it.
So I'm really excited that we take the next leg of the journey together, that we combine our knowledge, experience, and strength and vision to create something that hopefully is exponentially greater and better, you know, for mankind, for our own fellow teammates, and for our investors.
So I think for us, what it does is it helps, you know, kind of turbocharge our efforts and take our efforts to the next level.
All I can say is welcome aboard.
Thank you. Thank you. Good to be here.